I seen the best of them, Jando. 25 to life in the can't stop. Never met a man that they can't talk. We're talking on the phone, they can hear us.
When you got dumb cake up in the say that they be waiting for you in the bushes with the duct tape. Up and down the interstate. Yeah, we really touch.
We touch.
October, I'm about to another state. He went down in Arizona, don't get me involved. An empty box in the car means they coming for all. I had six phones, I got rid of them all. We get hit and sit down, we don't talk to the law. Yeah, they think I'm tripping, they listen. They know our every move, yeah, they want us all in prison. That's why I can't sleep at night until they get in. I'm on another mission, I'm just young and I'm living.
I done seen the best of them, Jando. 25 life in the can't stop. Never met a man that they can't talk. We're talking on the phones, they can hear us.
7 in the morning and they in my home. My bank account's froze, what is going on? Why it all start going wrong?
My phone still echo, the feds won't let go. Money never sleeps when you're the Black Gordon Gecko. Line looking like they waiting on the retro. Sixes, I feel special. Resale and I never pay retail. Money afforded me the spree wells. And that then courted me a V12. Avoid the phones if it's sounding like a seashell. Too much clicking in the connection. Connect the dots with my connect for my protection. Face to face, I place my like a drive through. Feeling, you know how I do.
All right, coach, EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. It's certainly hot outside here in the desert, but somehow this Cardinal crowd turned up the heat a moment ago. They were in a frenzy as their team emerged from the tunnel, and the Cardinals, they're set to do battle with the Jacksonville Jaguars. Josh Lambeau now ready to put this one in the air. And in front of a raucous crowd, this one is underway. That'll be taken in the end zone. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Johnson. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, he breaks through.
Blitz coming and down he goes. Yannick Ngakoue in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10.
So what's the word I'm looking for here about how this drive just started?
Disjointed?
I'll go with that one. I mean, think about it. First down, took a bad loss on a running play. Take the sack on second down. Now they got to come up with something big here on third.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that Tucker rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass. Here's the veteran punter, Lee, as he sends this one away. And taken right on the 30. A good return there, 17 yards. And the Jags will have great field position to start this drive as they take over on the short side of the field. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10. On the ground, this is T.J. Yeldon. And he'll lose his yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. On second down, here's Bortles. Flush to his right. They find Yeldon. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. It's a gain of five. And just like that, it's third down. For midfield, here's Bortles. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning, hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble.
And that's what friends are for.
Right. As the returner, you know who you're buying dinner for later.
Oh, without a doubt, because he just took care of you and your team in a big way. You know, you turned it over there. That's a big momentum changer and put your defense in a bad spot.
Bradford now to throw on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Well, it doesn't take any great analysis. No jokes, partner, okay? All right, on this one. But we just know that we're going to see this as the game moves forward. There's going to be two guys on him on just about every snap.
It's kind of a dare to throw his way, but they have to keep throwing his way.
The benefits could be great. You throw it to a great receiver, he could come down with it anyway.
He'll wind up losing three, and now it's third down. And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? Almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility?
Three down, Mark. Three down. Four down.
Third and long for Bradford. And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get forward progress. That'll be a safety. Well, we thought these two defenses, they might come to play. One has already come to play here. A safety for the opening points of the game.
Brandon, let's file this play away, because if it turns out to be a tight game, who knows? This could wind up being the difference.
And it's taken in at the nine. The Jaguars getting set to go. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Ah,
the
leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Bortles now on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Play clock down to five, and they're going to burn a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten. A first carry for Leonard Fournette. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. He only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a third and eight forthcoming. Bortles now to throw. Oh, and he'll just get rid of this one deep. And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. Give him 35 yards there on the third down conversion. Let's go, let's go. So in the Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 32-yard line. They'll run it down out of the gun. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Well, that play was doomed right from the start. Let's go, let's
go. They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
Here we go, here we go.
Bortles to throw on second down. He'll get this over to Westbrook. It's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line.
He's known for his hands defensively, but instead it just brings up fourth down. On is Josh Lambeau now for the Jaguar field goal. From the right hash, this from 44 yards out. And Lambeau will put this one through, and that will give us the very rare scoreline of 5-0. So it's our first offensive points of the game so far, and it gives us a very rare scoreline. We don't see this one often, 5-0.
Yeah, it's been sort of a weird one to this point, hasn't it? But hey, in this league, you take points any way you can get them.
And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. And the Cardinals getting set to trot out there now. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get. And it's just so strange to see that go up on the board. And then you got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points.
He gets it left side to Johnson. And he's able to get this one up to the 45-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up the defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, but they'll abandon it now after getting only one on that play.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Here we go.
So it can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player? Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
On third down, Bradford is going to let this one go deep. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-round pick, DJ Hayden. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Bortles leads the Jags up first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. So after the INT, it's Bortles. He's going to air one. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 47. On first and 10, here's Bortles. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Back to the air on second down. It's Bortles. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on third.
Trying to get that one to his tight end, and they've been trying to get the ball to him, but as of yet, unable to successfully complete one. But you know, there's usually a nice comfort zone in throwing to the tight end. Great sight lines, usually right in the middle of the field.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll go for it. It's Bortles. And my goodness, this is incomplete. The Jags come up empty on fourth down. And the Cardinal defense is going to get the football back. So the defense has to stay out and get one more stop. They were able to do it, forcing the incompletion.
So on their record, that goes down as a successful play. It doesn't matter how they got there, how it happened. They got it done. They're the ones that are jubilant.
One day. Turbo.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And his throw here is incomplete. It was the free safety to Sean Gibson who was able to range over and knock it away.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now it's a bootleg with Bradford. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
The Cardinals on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 10.
We got four. Here we go. 5-2. Here we go.
Play action now. Bradford. And he finds his man. That's Butler. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. Give him 30 yards there.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Looks for Nelson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Well, partner, I do know this. If you're a defensive back, you have more chances to make a team now than ever because people are using 5 defensive back, 6 defensive back packages. Not exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there, and what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier downs than ever before. This has become a passing league, and because of that, more defensive backs on the field on most plays.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. And last time, decent field position, threw the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Back to it after the pick six. Bradford. From left side, caught by Butler. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 30 yards there.
Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them, but a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making an adjustment. Sometimes it's just going back to what you know can work and finally getting it done.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four. Earlier this half, you were wondering how the defense was going to handle him defensively. Were they going to bottle him up at different levels, so to speak, is what you said. What have you seen so far?
Well, I think they've been absolutely terrific because it feels like on every play, if we were watching this in the film room, when you clicked off the film or stopped it, you would see 11 shirts of that same color right there in the frame trying to tackle it. That's what you're looking for.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. To throw, Bradford. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Barry Church. So that is 3 interceptions now in this first half, and you hate to ask the question, but let's be honest, we're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here, but he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out a little bit.
Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. So good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
They'll run it again with Fournette. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed. And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Jaguars in possession of the lead, and they will get the football as we are underway in the second half. That's fielded in the end zone. And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. And they take over already 5 yards deep into the red zone at the 15-yard line.
Let's just call that play exactly what it is. Needed, because they wanted to get back in the game, and they knocked the ball free, and now they have a chance to do exactly that.
They got the chance. Now they have to take advantage. Bradford on first down. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Tashawn Gibson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
Bortles now on first down. And Austin Seferian Jenkins has it. And he's brought down after a good game. Give him 30 yards there.
If a post pattern is often equated as a changeup route, how about when you throw it to your big guy down the center of the field? Covered or not, you have great confidence he's going to come down with the football. And when he does, as we just saw, long gains often result.
Throwing on first down is Bortles. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Marcus Golden coming hard that time. He's able to run him down for a loss of 12. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Now Bortles throwing on second down. Flushed out right. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Marcus Golden in there again as he's able to pick up sacks on both first and second down. On third and long, it's Bortles. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. It's caught inside the 25. And he takes it down deep into Arizona territory. A big play there. Bortles to lead. 59 yards. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10. As they've got things rolling on this drive. Into the red zone, it's Bortles. And that's incomplete. D.D. Westbrook, his intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Bortles again here on second and 10. Eluding the pressure right. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Chandler Jones able to collapse the pocket and drop it for a loss of a yard. Following the sack, third and long for Bortles and the Jags. Now Bortles. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the veteran Antoine Bethea.
And you can't say enough about our man making the interception right there, Brandon. It's his 12th year in the league, and you told me before the game that he still got it, and he does. What a play that was to come away with the football.
Following the interception, Bradford. And the pressure gets to Bradford, and down he goes. Dante Fowler in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. On second down, Johnson. Oh, and Nelson's spaced to operate. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. That one good for 14 yards. And that'll lead here to a third down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, I know the great
Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar sack. Yannick Ngakoue in there to drop him for a loss of 10, and it'll be fourth and long. Here's Andy Lee now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Fielded just inside the 30. Great blocking on the return. It springs him for 25. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field.
11.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And now another turnover as this one's intercepted. Picked off by Jamar Taylor. Muscles him off. And it's a big turnover there on the final play of the quarter. Throw for the backup, Rosen. Throw left side, complete. It's Butler. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. They give him a gain of 38.
That crossing route is so effective when you hit it just right, because you get a guy on the move, and then we see the end result there.
Nightmare for the defense. They got a guy with a full head of steam.
Not only does he catch it, but he picks up additional yardage after it.
Now a play fake here on first down. And oh, look at that, a diving catch. 12 yards that time for number 12 as they move the chains.
It must be something about the night air, because he is putting on an absolute show under the light.
Yeah, we've established anything in his vicinity, he's grabbing it. The red zone now. Here's Rosen on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long. And they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard. Rosen again on second and 10. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. This drive, which was going so smoothly, all of a sudden it's a little bit of a roadblock here with two straight incompletions.
Yeah, apparently this defense has had enough. Apparently they're saying, no more. We're making a stand right here, right now. But it is third and 10. They've got to get after him one more time.
The Cardinals on third down. They've had their troubles. Just 1 for 6. This is third and 10. Again, it's Bradford. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Yannick Ngakoue in there to get him for his second sack of the night.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. 5 sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. It's Rosen on fourth down. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked up by Jalen Ramsey. And he will bring this all the way up to the 30-yard line. Maybe he telegraphed it a little bit right there. You've got a quarterback knowing that he's going against a rookie quarterback. He stepped in and picked it.
You think he had a great week of preparation, looking forward to this opportunity? And the second part of that is, when you're a young quarterback, you are going to stare down targets, but oftentimes your playbook hasn't expanded to give you full field reads as well. Makes it a little bit tougher for him.
And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my, he pulled it in. It's a big play. Bortles to Westbrook, 48 yards. So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 22-yard line.
Here we go.
On first down, Bortles. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
I know you felt like saying touchdown there, didn't you, partner? That looked like a sure 6 points, but the contact jarred it free.
Got his hands on it, could not hold on through the end of the play. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Bortles will try again on second down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Josh Bynes coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. Following the sack, third and long for Bortles and the Jags. Working from the gun, it's Bortles. Letting one go deep. And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. DJ Chark, 29 yards. And the Jaguars add 6 to their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Extra point tacked on by Lambeau, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. Just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. A really good pickup of 28 yards. This quarterback now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10.
Over. Leopard.
They go play action here on first down. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Talvin Smith in there to get him the 6th time they've sacked him tonight.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle
it. And the pressure gets to him again. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set.
I think normally we would talk about this more with basketball players and football players, but let's adopt it in this case. He's a stat sheet stuffer.
Had the interception earlier, now a sack. But he just needs a touchdown for the trifecta.
That's about all he needs, and he's going to go for it.
That's caught by Butler over the middle, and he'll get it down to the 47 here. A crazy sequence here. A huge gain that time, but it still leaves him well short for 4th down. Well, the offense failed earlier on the previous crack at this, but they're going again on 4th down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And now here's another interception. Picked off by the former first-round pick, DJ Hayden. And he'll actually lose 6 yards on the return, but I don't think they care. They've got the football back.
Here we go.
Bortles going to throw here. He's going to air one out. He's got a man complete. Touchdown, Jaguars. DJ Chark, 84 yards. And the Jaguars add on to their lead.
Well, I've got a lap here, and I really don't want to because the old school in me is not happy about this score this late, not necessary. But this is Madden, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is how it works.
Rub it in. Have a day.
I mean, what does it matter? These guys who are playing in this game, there are no feelings.
Exactly.
There.
They don't have to face the guy. Well, they might if they're in the same room going head to head.
But that's
the
about
virtual
it.
Guys on the screen don't have to face each other after this one.
In that case, run it up.
Here's Lambeau out to kick this one away. Short kick. One of the up middle take it now. Well, in this one, partner, we had some action all the way down to the final whistle there with the late points and then the kickoff to end it.
Yeah, and the best part about it is just seeing how teams battled all the way to the end, you know. Didn't really matter. Scoreboard was pretty well set, but they still competed until the final whistle.
Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to the StubHub Center, 20 miles south of downtown L.A. I'll tell you, you wouldn't think 30,000 people could make this noise. That's half the size of a normal NFL stadium, but this is no normal crowd. They are ready to go as their Chargers get set to match up with Matt Ryan and the Atlanta Falcons. Caleb Sturgis now to do the honors and get us started. And we are underway in Southern California. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. Three,
They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through.
They give them 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
A nice little screen. They get six on first down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Here's Ryan. And Jones has it over the middle. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. Ryan to Jones, the Falcon connection there for a first. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. On second down, Freeman. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and now they're looking at a 3rd and 13. The 7th play now of this opening drive. This is 3rd and long, though. Midfield now. Here's Ryan. And this is going to be incomplete.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. And it appears they'll go for it here on 4th down. A big call on the game's opening drive. They'll try and throw for it with Ryan. It's caught. Jones. Touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones. 50 yards. And the Falcons have taken the early lead. Wow, talk about a big 4th down conversion for the score defensively. How do you let that happen?
I think you start with the offense, and you give them credit for going for it and having that type of, well, let's face it, audacity. But defensively, I think you're right on target, partner. There's no way something like that's supposed to happen in that situation. You're supposed to be able to shut that down and get the ball back for your own team. Instead, they give up not just a big play, but a touchdown.
And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. So Rivers will lead the Chargers up 1st and 10 at their own 27. Now a first carry for Melvin Gordon. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Rivers now on second down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Grady Jarrett continuing to fight downfield. The big tackle gets him for a loss of 11. Back now to begin the second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's the Chargers here with a football. They do, however, have a tough third and long coming up. And with the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. So it's third and long for the Chargers and Rivers after the sack. From the shotgun, it's Rivers. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. It's Desmond Trufant, and they will take over at the 26-yard line.
Well, it's third and long, and you've got a few different ways to play it offensively. But this is not the type of offense that's going to wave the white flag. They're going to keep chucking it, and this time, it results in an interception.
After the interception, here's Ryan. Complete over the middle to Hardy. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one.
Hey, Tuesday. Well, let's go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, so it was looking good, but nothing there. Now it's third down and inches. Under 4 to play now. Clock running, third down. Now it's Ryan. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Falcons will extend their lead. There are several elements to a well-executed screen pass. This one resulted in a touchdown. It had all of those elements.
Hey, you're so right, because you really need the rush to almost get to the quarterback, almost get to the passer. Then you've got to get the ball thrown perfectly, whether it's to the running back, the wide receiver, whoever the screen guy is. And, of course, the blocking has to form in front to get him downfield for the touchdown.
Here's Bosher to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. The Chargers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. They'll start the drive with a run by Gordon. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
No gain on that run, and while this team is down, they're not out of it by any stretch of the imagination. Maybe you just have to think about a different style of running in order to get this guy going.
Hurry up!
On second down, they'll run with Gordon. And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. Tackle made by Devondre Campbell.
Gets it to the 34, good enough for the first.
The Charger first down, Rivers hooking up with Allen. Two minutes to play here in the first half. We'll come back to Southern California after this. First down, and the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
Vision is so important for the man in the middle because his ability to look through all the clutter that's happening in front of him, diagnose a play, and then go make it and finish it, that's when the great ones know that they have the goods.
Now a second down throw for Rivers. Across the formation, he's got a man. That's Allen. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. They get nine out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. The first down throw here for Rivers. Forced out to his left. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Second down, Rivers. Whipping one into Allen. That's complete. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. This is Melvin Gordon, and that play will go nowhere, losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. He lost two, and it brings up fourth.
We just saw another example of how the defense is winning this game. Really, at the point of attack, the offensive line is just getting pushed around. I think now, as a play caller, you've got to give them a little bit of help. Maybe you keep your tight ends a little bit more. Maybe the running backs help you a little bit with the pass blocking. But you've got to help them get some confidence, because you can't abandon the play calling right now.
Going deep here for Allen. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. Final play of the half, it's Ryan. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of his first half of play. So we have reached halftime now with the visiting Falcons out on top. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Out comes the Chargers as they'll go on offense now to start this third quarter. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there, because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Charger first. Rivers going to turn and give this one to his running back, Gordon. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
They keep it on the ground. Again, Gordon. And he's got some space here. And he's brought down. 17 yards for the Chargers there as they've got themselves a first down.
Would you say this offense is locked in right now?
They're having no trouble on this drive. What is it, 3 plays? 3 first downs.
Yeah, you talk about on the march. They keep this up, they'll get to that end zone real fast.
From Falcon territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 38. Now Rivers going to give it off to Gordon. Oh, now he bowls him over. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. Now the handoff comes to Gordon, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, 2nd down.
While there was no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window. They've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
Out to his left. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's 3rd down. The Chargers on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7.
4 down, 4 down.
Now a 10th carry for Melvin Gordon. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th.
And Sturgis able to knock it through. And they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3. So three drives now for this offense, and that field goal gives them their first 3 points.
So if you're an offensive coordinator and you're averaging a point a drive, you're in the wrong line of work, aren't you? You got to find a way to unlock the key to these defenses and put some big points on the board.
On the return, here's Justin Hardy. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Here comes the Falcons offense. It's their first possession of the second half now. The third quarter has not been kind to them. After they built that lead at intermission, they've seen that lead shrink.
And how much of that is simply execution? How much of that is maybe you lose your edge a little bit because you've got a lead? And you do have to credit the other team some because they've made some adjustments to start to slow them down. Can they find those counters now, those extra plays or plays they haven't run that'll be effective and get them back moving again?
They'll be looking for something here, anything to seize that momentum back.
All right, let's go.
On second down, Ryan. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Casey Hayward. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Following the interception here, Rivers. And that's complete to the right side of Taylor. A good pickup there, a 22. A nice little completion there by Phillip Rivers. And you and I were reading the article yesterday. Fifth grade, Rivers had to do a project where he had to make a poster about his dreams and aspirations. So he clipped out a football player from a magazine article and pasted his face on the helmet. That's what he wanted to be, and it turned out okay.
Not so bad. Not so bad at all. Remember, he's the son of a coach. And on that play, I think he made the old coach proud with that completion.
Now a handoff. This is Gordon. About 3 yards there to the 27.
I think they want to start getting back into this game. It behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive. Fake to Gordon. Now Rivers. Throw right side, complete to Williams. And he's brought down. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Charger first. But correct me if I'm wrong, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Gordon. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes, and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what'll be a third and four. And this defense continues to give them fits. They just can't get really anything going on the ground, can they?
I love the theme that you just brought up. This defense has been tough all game long against the run. We just saw another example of it there.
Now Rivers. And this is hauled in by Williams for a Charger touchdown. Tyrell Williams from 10 yards out. And the Chargers capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six. All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. They're going to give it to Gordon. And he will get into the end zone to shave two more points off the deficit. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. Now Hardy on the return. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Atlanta now coming out on the field. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. One score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping Chili on the other side of the ball. Said, hey, we picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw it with confidence. If there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the two-minute warning. Taken down at the 46-yard line. A gain of four that time as the drive continues. And it's defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the two-minute warning.
Let's go! Hey, let's go!
They'll throw on first down with Ryan. Got his man completely in the middle. It's Jones. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Whistles and a timeout at the 2:05 mark. So this defense wanting to get one more pause in before the two-minute warning, and they do just that. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. This is Colbert. And he will be stopped here for no gain, and that is going to take us to the two-minute warning. He'll be brought down at the 43. Joey Bosa in on the stop. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. The battle in the trenches never more important than right now. This is third and inches. Back to the ground, this time with Freeman. Freeman a first down and more. Devontae Freeman, they're not going to get him. Touchdown, Falcons. Devontae Freeman, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. They get one more as the extra point's up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Here's Bosher to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Chargers getting set to go. And that last touchdown drive they had very balanced. How key is that balance?
It's huge because most of the time when we talk about balance is run, pass, almost 50-50. But most of the times when you start the offensive coaches, they say balance is we do what we want when we want to. And that means that they're ahead of the defense, keeping them on their heels.
Well, they imposed their will on that last drive. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives them a new set of downs. Here's Rivers. And his throw is incomplete.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, help force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete.
Set! Delta!
behind.
Rivers to throw. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down.
Remember, throughout my career here, and defensive coaches always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. Well, they put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed.
He's got his man here. It's Green. And he takes this one into the end zone, and all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
A little surprising they wouldn't go for two, but this is up and good. Time definitely of the essence now, just under a minute to play, and here we go. So that one will be accepted. Very good starting field position for the Falcons offense as they come up first and 10. The Falcons in victory formation as they take a knee. Clock counting down toward 40 seconds as they take the knee.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right, just us against the world and get it done, how happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something, and they did in this one. Ryan heads down to a knee, and that should wrap this one up. Well, as always, partner, an extreme pleasure to share a booth with you. I have to say, I am impressed at your discipline because you came here and you said you were not going to eat any of the media buffet. You made it to the end. You didn't consume a single calorie.
I appreciate that. What you missed is me going to the concession stand outside of your eyesight and getting it done that way. Look, I mean, they were serving the good stuff. I had to do it.
Oh, man, but you're svelte, in good shape, but yeah, you cheated a little bit. We'll let it slide.
I appreciate that. Always a pleasure to work with you.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. With that, we say so long from Southern California.
Dump.
cake up in the say that they be waiting for you in the bushes with the duct tape up and down the interstate. Yeah, we really touch.
We touch
October. I'm about to another state.
He went down in Arizona. Don't get me involved.
An empty box in the car means they coming for all.
I mean, it's
I had six phones. I got rid of them all.
We
get hit and sit down. We don't talk to the law. Yeah, they think I'm tripping. They listen.
They
know our every move. Yeah, they want us all in prison. That's why I can't sleep at night until they get in. I'm on another mission. I'm just young and I'm living.
Yeah,
I done see the best of them jammed up. 25 life and they can't stop. Never met a man that they can't talk. We're talking on the phones, they can hear us.
7 in the morning and they in my home. My bank account's froze, what is going on? Why it all start going wrong?
My phone still echo, the feds won't let go. Money never sleeps when you're the Black Gordon Gecko. Line looking like they waiting on the retro. Sixes, I feel special. Resale and I never pay retail. Money afforded me the spree wells. And that then courted me a V12. Avoid the phones if it's sounding like a seashell. Too much clicking in the connection. Connect the dots with my connect for my protection. Face to face, I place my like a drive-thru. Feel it, you know how I do. Push.
I done seen the best of them jammed up. 25 life and they can't stop. Never met a man that they can't talk. We're talking on the phones, they can hear us.
7 in the morning and they in my home. My bank account's froze, what is going on? Why it all start going wrong?
Talking on the phone. Too many to handle business on my own, cause you ain't right, and that's I don't condone. I got homies behind the wall wishing they was home. They got jammed up, kept discussing business on the phone. But Scotty, boy, we 200 bands off them $20 flips. I'm going by myself when it's time to f*** up. That way police don't have a clue when turn up. I'm dolo when I'm out making different moves. Pull up to the shop just to pick and choose. I'm that, don't get confused, cause even when them prayed I didn't lose. Machine.
I done seen the best of them jammed up. 25 life in the can't stop. Never met a man that they can't talk.
Running the more.
Now, why did they trash? 734. That's
hot. I can see you hang with the door closed. Now I'm looking for a glove with the sparkle on.
Monday, down. 183. 2093.
Twice with the arm, you know, you ever been hit with the water, then had to wait till you
what a wave, you know, you know.
Now, you
we are the guy, Golden State, and you and the team are the most critical, you know, you know. Been granting wishes like a genie to bed in two-piece bikinis. I've been hiding where you can see me. The skybox is right next to Reese's. So responsible for showing rappers how to stand on the front lines when started throwing bands. Where were you in bed? Brought the Tigers in. Cause I was busy earning stripes like a tiger skin. Players in ball shorts, coaching from the side of the ball court. If you know, you know. One stop at the Walmart. We got the wrong sport. You know, you know. If you know about the court, though it's supposed to be awkward. If you know, you know. That's the reason we for circle round twice with the hard court. You know, you know.
Now, you ready? 734 Express. What's up? Now, we're waiting. What's up?
too much clicking in the connection. Connect the dots with my connect for my protection. Face to face, I place my like a drive-thru. Feel it, you know how I do. Push.
I done see the best of them, Jango. 25 life in the cast off. See the best of them, Jando. 25 life in the cast on. Never met a man that they can't talk. We're talking on the phone, they can hear us.
7 in the morning and they in my home. My bank account's froze, what is going on? Why it all start going wrong? From talking on the phones. Ubers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stress. I'm really just running for money. I'm love flow, Joe chasing the check. I'm really gonna run up the money. I'm Carlos, really running the best. Car moving through these Ubers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stress. Car moving through these Ubers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stress.
Right. Couldn't hit if had I ain't. Lanes can't call and you lame. You had it and you lost it, all the shame. I can buy a Billy, don't talk to me. For sure, 150, don't talk to me. You ain't never helped your mans, don't talk to me. You should follow all the trends, don't talk to me. I set the bar, I'm a bar. Get the sky, I'm a star. I'm full of love, cause I'm 11, I'm 11. They ain't like my shirt, it's a large. I don't care how I crush the ghost. Got two cribs and two states, I can do the most. I got white folks money that I won't blow. And if you ask why, cause the white folks don't. Big bang, tight, no buy. Big bang, tight, no buy. Buy. Type of money you gon' lose. Type of money you gon'
lose. Now, we waiting.
Type of money make you stay up. Type of money you gon' let you.
Big bang, tight, no
buy. Everything probably yeah. Top account of gold yard batting down. Big, big, a lot
of flights. We waiting. That's up.
Corporate enough. Shout, you ain't off
often enough, a rapper turn can morph into us, but a turn rapper can morph into puff. There's contest for the I predict Al Roker. If you know, you know. I only ever looked up to you all get a bird. This is Oprah. Players in ball shorts, coaching from the side of the ball court. If you know, you know. One stop like a wall. We got the
for
the wrong sport. You know, you know. If you know about the court, though it's supposed to be awkward. If you know, you know. That's the reason we for circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know. You ever been hit with the water? Then had to wait, do you walk away? If you know, you know. When we all clicking like Golden State, and you and your team are the motorcade. If you know, you know. Been granting wishes like a genie to bad in two-piece bikinis. I've been hiding where you can see me. The skybox is right next to Riri's. Solely responsible for showing rappers how to stay. Started throwing bands. You and Big brought the Tigers in, cause I was busy earning stripes like a tiger skin. Players in ball shorts, coming from the side of the ball court. If you know, you know. One stop at the Walmart. We got the for the wrong sport. You know, you know. If you know about the court, though it's supposed to be awkward. If you know, you know. That's the reason we circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know.
Girl, you know you a bad. Girl, you know I'm a savage. They gon' let me in this club in these dirty vans. Clean money, I count stacks with these dirty hands. Do a show, cop the rack with my new advance. 50 bands, 80 bands, 100 bands. I'm the American dream. We the American dream.
American dream. No money, no class, look at them. Another day in the USA. Just another day in America. Kids from my hood look up to the system set.
If the squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Yeah. Hey. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah.
Hey.
Hey. Hey. Hey. Same squad. Same squad. Same squad. Drop top coupe, Dodge Range drives. Big plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad. Same squad. Same squad. Big plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Cross move quick like AI. Chain shine bright like daytime. Stack big bread like waist high. I don't do lanes. Lil' b- watch, y'all like 2 Chainz. I done swerved in a new lane. Bang at the grit, do things. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge Range drives. Big plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't.
All right, Coach, from one of the loudest venues in the NFL, there's a look at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the Arrowhead Stadium tunnels, and the noise level in this place was just about off the charts. They're set for football as the Chiefs get set to do battle with the Carolina Panthers. Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And into a sea of red, we're underway in Kansas City. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And he nearly broke that for more, but as it is, they'll start this drive at about the 37-yard line. Up to about the 38-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
That was a really nice play, being able to stack that one up. When they get back in the huddle, he's got to tell his guys up front, great job. They kept people off of him, allowed him to run free, and make the hit on the runner.
Filled the gap nicely, kept him to just a 1-yard gain. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. And he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41. Chris Jones on the stop. This defense looking for an early stop. This is third down and 6. To throw is Newton. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. Whoosh. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. And a nice gain of 21 yards. So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 38. Now a first down throw for Newton. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he's going to get this inside the 30. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So second catch on the drive, he may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, two catches. So if they can get him going in the passing game, it should open up his running game too. And a reinforcement's come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. On second down, here's Newton. Over the middle to Smith. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. A good pickup there, a 22. Great mix of play calling so far. 3 runs, 3 passes. All 3 passes have been completions. First and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up for it and see what happens.
They go play action here on first down. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the free safety, Eric Berry. And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 from back at their own 10-yard line.
Money! Left, left, blue 45, left, left, blue 45.
They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And not much there at all, as he'll get this only up to about the 11. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
Throwing on second down. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And he's brought down after a good gain. Give him 30 yards there.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden, as the Chiefs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter. And they've got it here with a first down. Carry now for Kareem Hunt. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. And he's going to be swallowed up. Sacked back at the 45-yard line. K'Wan Short busting through to get him for a loss of 6. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Mahomes to throw on second down. And going deep for Hill. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown.
Tyreek Hill, 54 yards. And the Chiefs are in for six. Extra point right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. Butker now to kick this one away. Was fielded at the 2. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And onto the field, here come the Panthers. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
They start on the ground with McCaffrey. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Robert Golden, the one who got him down.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. To throw on second down is Newton. Now they go screen. It's complete. And now running right through it. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down. Hands on it, but couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down.
But nearly another interception there. That would have been 2 drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Here we go. No move to get the offense off the field. They're going on 4th and 5. They are going to go for it. It's Newton. He sets it, and that's caught inside the 35. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. And caught left side, Olsen. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. We're back to Arrowhead after this. So second and inches after that first down completion went just shy of the marker. Throwing again is Newton. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. A great play there. A 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. Extra point try good by Gano. And we are tied at 7. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory,
Why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Well, the former LSU Tiger Dante Jackson on the stop. Pickup of 33 yards. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Again with Hunt. And some space here.
Oh,
he will not. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. A great effort there as the first half is winding down. And the Chiefs are in for six.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 14-7. Butker now to kick this one away. This is taken at the three. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Now Newton on first down. It got his man complete. A big play there just before halftime. 41 yards.
Here we go. On the ball, on the ball, on the ball, on the ball.
The final shot before the break, Newton. And that'll be incomplete. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half.
This will be taken in at the one. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10, right at the 30. They'll start with Hunt on the ground. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
They'll run again with Hunt. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them.
Second sack now of the afternoon.
Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. From the gun, it's Mahomes. He's going to float this over the middle deep. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And Kansas City touchdown. Tyreek Hill, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. Butker now to add the extra point. The extra point splits the uprights. And it's now 21-7. Now to kick this one away. The Panthers offense now, they head back on the field for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short. Here we go. The gun, Newton. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43, and the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. Here's Mahomes.
And he goes out of bounds inside the 10 at the 9. A really... Nice gain of 25 yards.
Hey, pull down, pull
down. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. Here's second and goal, operating from the 8-yard line.
Here we go now.
They get it to him running left. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. A great play there with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And thanks to the interception, the Chiefs offense cashes in with 6. Butker on for the PAT. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Butker now to kick this one away. This will be taken about the 12. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. Carolina getting set to take the field. So Newton and the Panthers come up now first and 10 at their 36-yard line. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Flush to his right. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. Call it a gain of 5. And it'll make it second down. Here's Newton now on second down. He'll drop it off to McCaffrey. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. Call it a 3-yard gain, and that'll make it third down.
Let's go. Gun, gun.
This is Newton off the play fake to McCaffrey. Blitz coming, and down he goes. D. Ford with a big-time sack on third down, and it'll be a loss of 7. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on 4th. We're back now in KC. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on 4th down.
Hey, 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 hey.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. He's going to go deep for Funchess. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. The coverage good that time by Kendall Fuller. Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down 3 scores, I guess they felt like they needed to push.
And let's face it, with this deficit, if they give up another score here after they didn't get it, does it really matter?
Right.
It really doesn't. They had to go and try and make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
Oh, no!
Mahomes going to hand it off to Hunt. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
They'll run it here with Hunt, and he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Stay on the ground. Again, it's Hunt looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a gain of a yard that time, but yeah, from the spot, actually no gain. So third and long.
And the Panthers bring in their nickel set as they try to defend here on third down.
Five defensive backs. Working from the gun, Mahomes. And that is incomplete.
Now, the secondary's really struggled today, but that's a little bit of a measure of revenge, isn't it? And they just followed the basic rules. See ball, knock ball away. Turns into a nice play.
Now, look at this. Fourth and 12, and they're going to line up to go for it. They'll go for it. It's Mahomes. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. Andy Reid went for it, but it won't pan out. And the Panthers will get the football back. So Newton and the Panthers come up now first and 10 at their own 26. On first and 10, Newton looking here for Smith downfield. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. A gain of 32 that time. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A good pick up there, 26 yards. From the red zone now, Newton. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Greg Olsen was the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
On second and 10, Newton. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Greg Olsen, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Panthers, they're able to draw a bit closer. Gano the extra point, and that cuts the lead to 28-14. Gano out to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can. He's got a man complete. A gain of 39 that time. And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 36. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. Hunt gets it on the draw from Mahomes, and he'll be taken down at the 34. And quickly, we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively.
Alert! Alert!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get down to about the 26-yard line. Give him 8 yards there. Still a few inches to go, though, as it'll be third down and about the length of the football.
Black 58 rail! Black 58 rail! Ready! Green 39!
Mahomes looks to throw on third down. They'll go screen here to Hunt. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. A great effort there. 26 yards. And the Chiefs add on to their lead. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. Butker now to kick this one away. And the kick goes outside the white lines. That's why the flag comes out.
Yes, and that was an error by the kicker, and it will give the offense great starting field position.
Good starting position for the Panthers as they come up first and 10. Newton on first down. He's going to let it fly. This is caught inside the 15. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. As he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Greg Olsen with now 2 fourth-quarter touchdowns. And the Panthers are able to cut into this lead. Now Newton will bring the Panthers up to go for two. Newton to throw. And he's got it for the two-point conversion. So they tack on a pair more here to narrow that deficit a bit further. So two scores down. Time definitely not an ally, but here comes the onside kick. And the Chiefs are going to make the recovery. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. They'll run it now out of the gun. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Mike's got nine.
Interesting. Mahomes wants to throw it. Incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
They come up to the line now facing a 3rd and 10 after the incompletion. On 3rd down, it's Hunt, and he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. Now the Panthers going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. And no move to get the offense off the field. Despite failing once, they're going to go again here on 4th down. And he will not even make it back to the line of scrimmage. Andy Reid went for it, but it won't pan out. And the Panthers will get the football back. So they've gone for it twice now on 4th down of this game, and both times unsuccessful.
I wish we could hear the headsets now between the head coach and the offensive coordinator. Now that they're 0-for-2, if they get into a third situation, head coach might say, hey, you got anything for this one? Might get radio silence back.
Throwing is Newton. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's knocked away and incomplete. He was looking for the connection with Devin Funchess. And it's 2nd down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Back to the air, Newton on 2nd down. He's going to let it fly. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Steven Nelson able to get a hand in coverage. Tried to go for the big one there on 2nd down. Now they're likely down to their final 2 plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
The Panthers on 3rd down, just 1-for-3 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. And they're out of timeouts, remember, so this is going to have to be a delay. Delay of game penalty, ships them back 5 yards, makes it 3rd and 10. Throwing on 3rd down, Newton. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is intercepted, and that should do it.
All white, right. Couldn't hit if had ain't. Lanes can't call and you lame. You had it and you lost it, all the shame. Pain with the door closed. Now I'm looking for a glove with a sparkle on it. And my got chocolate on it. Big bank, take small. Make a count on some tall.